In this video, I will recap my Air Show experiences from 2023. The season is pretty much over in most places around the world, and I went to 2 air shows. This is also the second year I have been going to air shows, and normally there are only 3 shows in Norway each year, so I went to 2 or 3 in my country. Since I'm very into jets and airplanes and also capturing them, of course I brought my camera. For the most part I took pictures, but on the first air show this year I also tried filming a bit with my humongous 150-600mm lens, which I found out not to be the easiest thing to do. However, my dad also filmed a bit on the last air show, so I will show you guys some footage from both of them, starting with the most recent. At the end of the video, we'll have a look at some of the pictures I got from air show season 2023 to wrap it up, and I will say there's quite a good amount of bangers.
Today we are going to Telemark Air Show in Notodden, and we're almost there, and I'm with my epic dad.
Yeah! I'm epic! That's what counts.
I was planning to do this intro later, but we are late, which is his fault.
So I don't care. It's raining.
It's barely raining.
And it's gonna rain like this or worse the rest of the day.
It's always raining when we're going to air shows. It's a bit annoying, but still gonna take some good photos, I hope. Let's see some cool jets.
Not me, you.
Yeah, I'm gonna take some cool photos. And he's gonna
look,
see some cool
airplane,
jets.
Airplane, in the skies.
Yeah. You probably can't see it on camera.
That's a little look at some footage from air show season 2023. Not too much, but I can't wait for the next air show that I'm going to, which unfortunately probably isn't until next year. However, then I will try to film a bit more as well. The way that I will go through photos is that I have picked up my favorites and I will quickly show and talk about them. I won't show photos of every plane I have seen because I don't have pictures or good pictures of them. Of quite a few of the planes, I will show multiple photos and I will go through it alphabetically after the plane's names. So let's get started. So the first photo I wanted to show you guys is this one of a Brekkerboot Jungman. I'm just really happy with this shot, like the way the plane is really focused, the background is blurry, just that it worked out with a lower shutter speed. You see that there is motion in the propellers. It's just an overall great shot. The next one is just like to demonstrate how hard it is to get focus when you have a low shutter speed. Like, this is a decent photo. I think it would have been even better if it was even sharper. As though it's really, really hard to nail the focus with low shutter speed and the subject is moving, especially when there are multiple planes. The next plane is a DH-100 Vampire. I just think this plane is really cool. It's kind of historical because it was the first fighter jet that Norway had. What I'm not so sure about is whether this one belongs to the Norwegian or the Finnish Air Force, because I think these are like the marks of the Finnish Air Force, but also they said something about the plane belonging to the Norwegian Air Force, but I know that the pilot is Finnish, so I don't know. I'll do some research and I'll put the answer on the screen if I find out. Next shot is of an XTR-300. This one is also really, really good, like photography speaking, because it has low shutter speed. The plane is very, very, very sharp. The background is blurry. Next up is another one with low shutter speed, a padding shot. I think this one is a Harvard plane, a Grasshopper, same thing, low shutter speed. You see that there is motion in the propeller. The plane is pretty sharp. It could have been a little bit sharper like at the end, but it's a decent photo. Oh, we got some afterburner here. This is a classic shot. You just see the flames bursting, or yeah, at least inside the engine, I guess. We have another one, photopass they call it, where it like fly very, very slowly so all the photographers can get their shots. And I'm just really, really satisfied with this. This is probably the last time, or actually my first and last time, I will be able to see the F-16 from the Norwegian Army while it's still operating, because it's been taken out of operation this year. Probably not 100% yet, or maybe it has, I don't know. But during this year, it's only gonna be operational F-35s in Norway left. So this was really cool to be able to see the F-16 before it's being taken out from the Norwegian Army. But I will probably be able to see it again later, and definitely if I go to other countries, but not the one from the Norwegian Air Force. A really, really cool photo. This one is cropped a lot and I think it's taken on like 600 millimeters, but you see like the clouds forming over the wings. And then there's one of a P-51 Mustang. Also really happy with this one. It was taken on low shutter speed. And then there's a Saab-32 Lansen. This is a veteran plane from the Swedish Air Force. I think this is just after it has landed and it's like taxiing back to where the planes were like put up for display, I guess. Another one of the Saab-32 Lansen. When it's taking off, we got afterburner. This was actually really, really cool because when the planes were leaving, the air show was officially over. I just said to my dad that like, hey, can we just wait until the planes have left? Maybe I'll get some cool photos. And it was definitely, definitely well worth it, because at least on the last air shows I've been to in Norway, it's pretty like strict rules. So like afterburner and like the coolest things are not really shown that much. But when the Swedish or this and another Swedish plane took off, it was just full afterburner, and that was really cool. So when taking this photo, like my ears, they died because I didn't have any ear protection at all. But it was well worth it. So that's a cool afterburner picture. And there's another one
in the sky. Not the best photo, but better than nothing, right? Yeah, this one is the Draken. So that's the other plane that the Swedish Air Force shown on Telemark Air Show. This one is really cool. It's really sharp. You see like the parachute behind it. Just a classic shot. And this one as well, when it's taking off, full afterburner, was also really, really cool. Got this photo as well. You can like see like the flames going a long way back. It was really cool. This is another plane which the Swedish Air Force showed up with. It's a Saab 37 Viggen. It's a really, really cool fighter. Like, this is an amazing shot. I don't know what to say. This is also another one from Kjellefridag earlier this summer. It's a Saab 39 Gripen. This is the newest fighter from Sweden. Didn't get the best photos of this plane. Like, I feel like the first air show I went to, the photos were like, yeah, like the only good photo I was like really happy with was, or were the ones of the F-16. Like, this one is decent, but it's not good. Like, Kjellefridag was kind of a bummer. Like, the planes were cool, but the photos were like, nah. But Telemark Air Show, on the other hand, which was just a couple of weeks ago, I got really, really good photos, so I'm really happy with that. And the conditions might have had something to do with it too. This is another one from the Swedish Air Force. Like, if you guys haven't already realized, the Swedish Air Force is a lot better at showing up on Norwegian air shows than the Norwegian Air Force. Also, the Swedish Air Force has taken care of a lot of their older planes than what the Norwegian Air Force has. So they also have more to show, but the Norwegian Air Force step up the game. They actually had two different jets of this type on Telemark Air Show, so this is one of them. And then this is the other one. This one also I'm really happy with, the picture. Another one of the SK-60. And another one. So I got some really cool photos of the SK-60 plane. Yeah, this one is the Spitfire MKX-VI about to take off. This is the Spitfire and P-51 Mustang together. Like, this one, I'm like, it's a decent photo, but you see that the Mustang, it's a bit more in focus than the Spitfire, but both of them could definitely be in better focus. And that's what I find like really hard, because when I have a low shutter speed, because I want to see the motion in the propellers, when there's one plane, it's hard. When there are multiple planes, it's really, really hard to get both of them in focus. So maybe on this one, when it was flying in formations, and maybe should I like used a higher shutter speed and not like been able to get the motion in the propellers, but I don't know. I think we are coming to an end very soon. But this is the Westland VS-61 Sea King. This one the Norwegian Air Force actually showed up with, and it's also probably the last time I'm going to be able to see this on air shows, especially with the Norwegian Air Force operating it, because this one is going to be replaced with the Saab Queen, which is like upgraded model. But this photo I'm really happy with. It's flying very close to the ground, so you see grass all over the place. Yeah, that's actually it from Air Show Season 2023. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Go in and check out my website if you want to see more of the photos. I have actually created like an own site for all the different planes and helicopters that I've seen and that I have photos of, or good photos of at least. And so if you want to like check out like individual planes that I have taken photos of, you can go and do that. Or you can go and check out the album that I've created for Telemark Air Show 2023. And I probably will make more albums as well for the future air shows. I hope you enjoyed this video, and maybe I'll see you later. I hope so. Maybe not. I don't know. We'll see. Bye.